sweep to Hazrat Suddhi. So the now the result is that the total conclusion is that this ayah is about sadaqah nafila, and then the people should spend first on their own relatives, then first their parents, then the closest relatives, then all these people. Now it's a tradition or a fashion that people try to spend outside the family. So this is against the spirit of Islam. Islam always calls the people to spend on their own family members. Yes, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives more than that, then the entire ummah accordingly. يَسْأَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ. This ayah has been completed. Now, ayah number 216. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ. In this ayah, the obligation of jihad is mentioned. That jihad is necessary, it's farz. When it is farz, Hazrat Thanvi alayhi rahma has explained that it has conditions. When the conditions are maintained, found, then it is obligatory. Otherwise, it is not obligatory. Then it has two types, farz-e kifaya and farz-e ayn. When the attack is common, massive attack, in which every member has to be involved, and then the ruler, Islamic rulers, announces for common departure, then it will be farz-e-ayn. Otherwise, the selected people, as per the system, as per the government, they have to participate. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ. Fighting has been enjoined upon you while it is hateful to you. Hazrat Thanvi and Allama Suyuti, they have translated, explained, وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ means it is naturally hateful to you. طَبْعًا مَكْرُوهٌ لَكُمْ as logic, as it's being the path of Islam, the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a Muslim will not hate it. But naturally, because it is tough, a person has to face a lot of challenges, even the adversities, difficulties of suffer and this and that. So naturally, there is an amount of dislike. But logically, and having seen the virtues, and then the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a Muslim will not hate. وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ مَكْرُوهٌ لَكُمْ تَبْعًا لِمَشَقَّتِهِ. Jalalain said, تَبْعًا لِمَشَقَّتِهِ. And the same is the explanation of Allama Ibn Kathir. شَدِيدٌ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ مِنْ شَدِيدٌ عَلَيْكُمْ وَمَشَقَّةٌ وَهُوَ كَذَلِكَ فَإِنَّهُ إِمَّا أَنْ يُقْتَلْ whether he will be killed أو يجرح or he will meet with injuries مع مشقة السفر ومجالد مجالدة الأعداء. حضرت علامة جلال الدين, he said لميل النفس إلى الشهوات المحبوبة لهلاكها ونفورها عن التكليفات الموجبة لسعادتها. So the full ayah, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ. Fighting has been enjoined upon you while it is hateful to you. Then after that ayah is وَعَسَى أَن تَكَرَهُ شَيْئًا. The part of this ayah, وَعَسَى أَن تَكَرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَى أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ. But perhaps you hate a thing and it is good for you, and perhaps you love a thing and it is bad for you. So how it is bad, how it is good? Allama Jalaluddin, he said, "Huwa, you feel it bad. Antakrahu shayya. Why? Limayli nafsi ila shahawatil mujiba lihalakiha. The nafs doesn't want to face anything which is not good, which is not convenient. And how it is good? Because we are going to have shahada or fortunes, either ghanima or shahada. Therefore, it is better for you. Wallahu ya'lamu wa antum la ta'lamun. And Allah knows while you don't know. Wallahu ya'lamu ma huwa khayrun lakum. What is better for you? Wa antum la ta'lamun dhalik. And you don't know what is better for you. Fabadiru ila ma ya'murukum bihi. Allama Jalaluddin said, Fabadiru ila ma ya'murukum bihi. Then hasten to do what Allah has ordered to you. This is how Hazrat Thanvi alayhi rahma has also explained. Then the Muslim should not look at this and this. Just they should follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, because the benefit of a particular thing is known by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Now the next ayah is 2:17. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الشَّهْرِ الْحَرَامِ قِتَالٍ فِيهِ. About its background, the scholars have written, including Hazrat Thanvi alayhi rahma, that once upon a time it happened that Sahaba war on a journey, then unexpectedly, suddenly they had to fight with some group of their enemies, and then one person was killed by them. They understood that this is the last date of Jumadu Saniya. But it was the first date of Rajab, and Rajab is among the months in which Qital is not allowed. Then the non-Muslims, the people of Makkah at that time, they taunted, criticized, and then they spoke about this everywhere, that the Muhammad and his people, his friends, they don't respect even the months which are sacred. Then this ayah was revealed. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الشَّهْرِ الْحَرَامِ. They criticized, then Sahaba approached the beloved Prophet ﷺ and they asked that this and this happened, what is the clarification? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الشَّهْرِ الْحَرَامِ قِتَالٍ فِيهِ. They ask you about the sacred month, means about fighting therein. So qitalin fi will be badal of anish shahril haram. Qul qitalun fihi kabir. The first answer is that it is not good to fight in these months. Qul qitalun fihi kabir. Say, fighting therein is a great sin. Everybody speaks of that. But now let's analyze. What is the reality of this fighting which has happened unconsciously without any intention? Hazrat Thanvi said, aap farma dijiye ke isme khas taur par qital karna yani amadan jurm azim hai. If someone especially fights in this month intentionally, deliberately, then it's a great sin. But what happened is not deliberately. It is not intentionally, rather it happened without any intention. Now, what is your character? So this is counter question. That was the mere reply to the answer. قُلْ خِتَالٌ فِيهِ كَبِيرٌ. Now, وَصَدٌ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَكُفْرٌ بِهِ وَالْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ وَإِخْرَاجُ أَهْلِهِ مِنْهُ أَكْبَرُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. This is the list of their constant mischiefs, which are far graver than what happened this time. وَصَدٌ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. But averting the people from the way of Allah and disbelief in Him, and preventing a cross to Al-Masjid Al-Haram, and then waqf wa ikhraj ahlihi, and expelling the people of its own people from Makkah, akbaru indallah, are greater evil in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Hazrat Thanvi wrote that the summary of answer is that you should not raise this question. you have already committed so heinous crimes that you should not make this incident a matter of discussion. Wal fitnatu akbaru min al qatli, and fitna, creating disorder, chaos in the city, in the community, is greater than killing. Hazrat Dhanvi said, this fitna which you always cause is greater than this particular murder which has happened without any intention. وَلَا يَزَالُونَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ حَتَّى يَرُدُّوكُمْ عَنْ دِينِكُمْ إِنِ اسْتَطَاعُوا. Then further explanation of their character. وَلَا يَزَالُونَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ حَتَّى يَرُدُّوكُمْ عَنْ دِينِكُمْ إِنِ اسْتَطَاعُوا. And they will continue to fight you until they turn you back from your religion, if they are able. So this is their characteristic. This is their reality, that they always want to fight you. And this question is only a straw man, only a matter of just making issue, nothing else. وَمَنْ يَرْتَدِدْ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ فَيَمُتْ وَهُوَ كَافِرٌ فَأُولَٰئِكَ حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. However, they will try to turn you back from religion of Allah. That will be their effort, their struggle. But those who will turn due to their effort, they should hear and listen properly, attentively, that وَمَنْ يَرْتَدِدْ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِ, and whosoever of you reverts from his religion to this belief, فَيَمُتْ وَهُوَ كَافِرٌ, and he dies while he is a disbeliever, means after he reverts, he again doesn't come back to Islam. فَأُولَٰئِكَ حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. For those, their deeds have become worthless in this world and the world hereafter. وَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. And those are the companions of the fire, they will abide therein in eternally. So now two words, فَأُولَٰئِكَ حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. How their deeds will be in vain in this world. Hazrat Thanvi alayhi rahmah has explained that if they revert to disbelief, then their marriage will be invalid. Now their marital relation will not be valid Islamically. And if any Muslim among his own close relatives dies, then they will not have shares in inheritance. Then whatever sawab, whatever rewards they got by the previous deeds, all will go in vain. Then if they die, their funeral prayer will not be performed. They will not be allowed to be buried in the graveyards of Muslims. And وَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. And they will be forever in Jahannam. So this is the khasara, loss of Akhirah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. On the contrary, those who have believed and those who have emigrated and fought in the cause of Allah, those accept the mercy of Allah, and Allah is forgiving and merciful. Means these people will enjoy the mercies, the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the ayah number 219. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ قُلْ فِيهِمَا إِثْمٌ كَبِيرٌ وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ وإثمهما أكبر من نفعهما ويسألونك ماذا ينفقون قل العفو كذلك يبين الله لكم الآيات لعلكم تتفكرون. They ask you about wine and gambling. Say, in them is great sin and yet some benefits for people, but their sin is greater than their benefit, and they ask you what they should spend, say the excess beyond needs. Thus Allah makes clear to you the verses of revelation that you might give thought. So two things have been discussed in this ayah. The first is that they asked about khamr and wine. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in both there is a great sin. Some timely temporary benefits are there, but they are nothing compared to their harms and their losses. وَإِثْمُهُمَا أَكْبَرُ مِنْ نَفْعِهِمَا. Then وَيَسْأَلُونَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ. Again, we have already learned that they asked what to spend. So this is also related. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ. To spend, where to spend, and how much to spend. Some scholars said that this is regarding zakah. So that is very little amount. قُلِ الْعَفْوَ. Whatever is beyond your bare requirements, your own day-to-day need. So means when zakat nisab comes, then spend that particular 2.5. Kujil afwa. Now another ayah is fi dunya wal akhirah wa yasalunaka anil yatama qul islahul lahum khair وَإِن تُخَالِطُوهُمْ فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ الْمُفْسِدَ مِنَ الْمُصْلِحِ وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَأَعْنَتَكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. First of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threatened those who were making mistake in the wealth of orphans. Then the Sahaba, the companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, got very cautious. And it is mentioned, narrated on the authority of Hadrat Ibn Abbas. He said that لَمَّا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ وَلَا تَقَرَبُوا مَعْدَ الْيَتِيمِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ أَمْوَالَ الْيَتَامَى ظُلْمًا إِنَّمَا يَأْكُلُونَ فِي بُطُونِهِمْ نَارًا وَيَصْلَوْنَ السَّعِيرًا. So these ayah, which were very strict about any sort of mistake in the wealth of orphans, then the Sahaba got very, very, very much afraid, and the result was that in talaqa man kana indahu yatimun fa'azala ta'amahu min ta'amihi. They separated their food from theirs, wa sharabahu min sharabi, and their drinking from there. Faja'ala yafdulu min ta'amihi. Then their food which was rest, sometimes they used to eat and sometimes it used to be waste. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah, that the purpose of the early ayat was only that you should not cause them any loss. It doesn't mean that you separate everything of yours from theirs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want to put you in trouble. They are your brothers in Islam. Now you mix their things with yours, but don't do any justice with them. فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. To this world and the world hereafter. And they ask you about orphans. Say improvement of them is best. قُلْ إِصْلَاحٌ لَهُمْ خَيْرٌ. And if you mix your affairs with theirs, they are your brothers. And Allah knows the corruption from the goodness, and if Allah had willed, He would have put you in difficulty. Means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have not allowed you to mix yours one with them. Indeed, Allah is exalted and might, and Allah is wise, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed you to mix your things with them and eat together, cook together, stay together. So these were several ayat, I think 10 ayat, and we learned several teachings of the glorious Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to practice them.